Assalamu alaikum. This is Nimra Khan from Comsats University, Waha campus. My registration number is FA21BSE079. In this video assignment, I am going to tell general information, history, some archaeological sites, and other information regarding district Sawabi. Starting with some general information about Sawabi. Sawabi is the name of a city and district of KBK. Sawabi district is located between Swat, Kabul and Indus rivers. District of Sawabi contains four tehsils, namely Lahore, which is also known as Chota Lahore, Topi Tehsil, Razar Tehsil and Sawabi Tehsil. The predominant clan of this district is Yusufzai. Sawabi district has been lucky to get fresh water from the mountains up north and is rich in agriculture. Tobacco is a cash crop of Sawabi along with vegetables, wheat, sugarcane and maize. Its climate is well suited for citrus in particular, while other fruits like watermelon, peaches and apricots are also grown there. Some notable people from the district include Nawab Sir Sahib Zada Abdul Qayyum, founder of the Islamia College Peshawar, the veteran of the Kargil War, Captain Colonel Sher Khan, who is the recipient of Nishan-e-Haider, which is the highest military award of Pakistan. Hafiz Rehmat Khan, Mughal legend of Rohilkhand, was also from Sawabi. Now proceeding with the history, so Sawabi was not always inhabited by Pashtuns. Like back in BC times, Sawabi was the epicenter of Buddhist learnings. In the Gandhara period, quite like Taxila, Sawabi was in the center of learning in this triangular empire. Back in those days, this district was inhabited by Hindkuans, now referred as Hindko people, who are now mostly limited to Peshawar city. Alexander the Great of Macedon passed through Sawabi district in 326 BC at a place called Hund. Talking about some educational institutes, so even today the love for education has not diminished in this district. Sawabi district is home to many excellent educational institutes including Sawabi University, Sawabi Women's University, Gaju Khan, Sawabi Medical College and the most renowned Ghulam Ishaq Khan University. Now let's have a look on some archaeological sites. So as we know that Sawabi was part of Gandhara civilization and that is the reason that this place contains many important archaeological sites. Starting with Hund, Hund is an archaeological treasure. It was the capital of Hindshahi for nearly 300 years. Hund was actually Hind in ancient history. This was the only frequently used crossing point on the Indus River towards Hindustan. Even Alexander of Macedon used this crossing. The Gandhara people needed a fort protecting this strategic river crossing, so they built Hund Fort. Hund Fort has only a few walls left over from the last millennium and the rest has been occupied by people. It's a good thing the Khyber Pakhtunkhwa Archaeological Department now has a museum at Hund dedicated mostly to Buddhist artifacts and Pashtun traditions here. Hun still has several mines of undiscovered archaeological treasures buried underneath this build-up town, as evident from the half-open pit near Hun Museum. So these are some pictures of the Hun Museum and the remains of the Hun Fort. Panigat is another Gandhara archaeological site containing ruins of famous palace belonging to the queen of that era. Ranigat is 2500 years old, 2.5 hours from Islamabad and 122 kilometers. Ranigat Buddhist monastery ruins are on top of a mountain that miraculously has natural springs flowing from the top. It once housed a whole town full of people and monks back in the early 1st millennium AD. The most revered of monks housed themselves in rooms carved into solid stone like the one shown in image. A lot of the carvings have been destroyed during the terror eras of the KPK. Now what does the Ranigat mean? Ranigat literally means queen stone. It gets its name from the early positioned tower-like stone that rises 40 feet into the air from its narrow base. The rock has markings that indicate that it was once worshipped by the Buddhists. These are some images of the remains of Ranigarh. Now let's talk about some other tourist sites, starting with the Kundal Dam. Kundal Dam Sawabi was developed as tourist spot and irrigation dam for the locality. Kundal Dam looks beautiful during the evening time when the orange sunlight bounces off the water surface. Han Indus River Fish Point. During the summer months, the Han Indus River bank is full of families enjoying the cool water of the Indus River. Indus River widens and considerably slows down here. The fish you get at Han is incomparable anywhere. They have even boat on the river where they take you to the island in the middle of the river. Colonel Sher Khan Tomb and Museum. Colonel Sher Khan Monument and Navekali is tribute to Pakistan's gallant hero Captain Colonel Sher Khan Nishan-e-Haider Kargil War. A visit to offer prayer and gain some inspiration in process is worth it. The museum holds objects belonging to Sher Khan. Tarbela Dam Wall Wave Spot. This place is a source of attraction of tourists due to its scenic beauty. It is a sort of picnic point. There the tourists get the glimpse of the Tarbela Dam's massive wall. Tourists can also get a chance to get allowed into the dam site to see spillways and enjoy water sports. This district in fact possesses beauty and aesthetics which can be great spots for tourists' attraction, but many of us are unaware of them. Now let's have a look on some of the eye-catching mountains the district has. Karmar is the peak of the local mountains bordering Sawabi and Mardan district with huge olive farm at the base. This mountain is best place for hiking and touring. It is situated in Kaluhan Tehsil Reserve and District Sawabi. One face of the mountain is barren while other side is dense forest, which is really surprising. This mountain is also famous for the love story of Yusuf Khan and Sher Banu. Their shrines are also found there. Secondly, the Birgale is a beautiful and green village of District Sawabi. It is situated on northwest of Sawabi on mount and houses are built stepwise down the slope which present a very beautiful view. The people here are simple, sincere and hardworking. They are famous for their hospitality. The Mahaban Mountains in Gadun has a great scenic beauty. Mahaban, which means great forest, is situated in the north of Topi City, District Sawabi. The weather here is cold in summers as well. It won't be wrong if we call this place as hidden paradise. Camping pots are also made on this mountain for tourist attraction. At last, in conclusion, I would like to say that Pakistan is the country that is blessed by Allah in every aspect. It is full of treasures and beauties. All we need is just to explore them, and the government of Pakistan needs to put effort on it, and they can generate a great amount of tourist revenue from it.